Email signatures. Email signature is more than just your name and title. Okay, it's a part of your personal branding. You can make a statement about you and your business. Okay, like a business card, a reader will know who has written that email. Okay, you can tell the reader who you are and which company you are representing. So let us try to understand what we need to include in an email signature. Okay, your name, company name and your title. These are the mandatory things which you need to add in your signature. Okay, name and title of the company. If you are representing a company, then only you can write an company's title. Then contact information. If you are representing a company or you are having a business website, then you should always mention your business website link, at least one phone number. Email address, most of the experts are saying that email address is not a necessary thing, but if you need to add something, then you should add email address also. Okay, social links. These days many social media platforms are available, but we need to add only professional links only. Okay, LinkedIn is one of the best options. If you want to add any social link so that the user can go to that link and check out your professional profile, that is the only intention to add this thing. Okay, you can add logo or photo, but that is also optional. To make it attractive, you can always add a professional photo, but we need to take care few things. For example, it should be professional image and headshot is required. There is no need to add full body photograph in your email signature. Okay, if you want to give a corporate look, then in some companies they say ki, okay, we have to add some confidentiality statement in each and every signature. So that will be a standard thing which will be available in all the signatures. Sometimes some companies say we need to add few colors and fonts which represent the kind of work they are doing. So to match those things, these are common things which will be seen in all the signatures of the employees. Okay, corporate link, if some companies want their website link or some other branding link need to be added, then that will be part of your signature. Address, company address will be part of your signature. So if we add all these things which are recommended by a particular company, that will give a professional look to your signature. So these are the few things which we can add into our signature. Now while preparing our signature, we need to keep in mind few things. Let us discuss few of these. For example, it should be very simple. We don't have to give too much information in our signature. It will do nothing but distract the reader. We just want to tell reader who we are, who we are representing. Okay, what is our position in a company? If we are at a higher position, we can always add those things. So that is the only intention, and we need to attract user's attention also at the same time. So, but we have to keep it very simple. We can be very colorful also. One or two colors can attract reader. Okay, that can always attract reader's attention towards your signature, but don't use too many colors. Okay, sometimes using many colors in a signature, it looks childish. So we need to avoid too many, but we can use few colors. A black and white signature can also be a very good thing. You can choose some font, or it can be a bold option. So we can use black and white signature also. These days many online template builders are available which can be used to create your professional signature. It will really add value to your email also. So there are few things which we need to keep in mind while creating our signature, and these are the few things which we need to add in our signature. Some are mandatory but few are optional. Okay, so signature is nothing but something which makes a statement about you and your business, and it is like a business card. So use it properly within each and every email. Series of 6 videos, email etiquettes, covering these 6 topics: 10 golden rules, handling flaming, how to write a subject line, difference between formal and casual email, what is the importance of postscript in an email, how to make an impression through signature. Okay, so these are few of the topics which we have covered in this series. Hope you are enjoying all these videos. You can access these video by clicking on the channel link, then go to playlist and select email etiquettes. You can access all these 6 videos at a single location. So stay tuned, keep watching.